Yeah, no, there's another truth about sex that I think people always... No, but you're not talking about sex. No.
No, no, no. It's not about sex, actually. It's about love evolve.
Ah, okay. I'm going to cut that out. Ciao! Thank you and welcome to Lempies. As you know, the new Lempies is all about having a happy and a healthy lifestyle.
So today we are going to spill the truth on our relationship, breakups, makeups, and all everything that involve the behind the scene of Lempies. You see, I told you that you need to tell to let me talk. You are too bossy.
Do you really think I'm too controlling?
No, sometimes your personality, you know, is you are a little bit more stronger, strong woman.
Apart from I'm too controlling, another video is also always, most of the comments are like, Ali is too soft of a man, it's not man enough. Like, and for me it's always like, I don't care, soft or not, we are happy together and it's working, yes. That's the point. Well, before we get into the video, don't forget to subscribe, like and give us a comment if you enjoy this channel.
Yes.
I'm going to check on my pasta, sweetie. I need to check on my pasta.
Not bad. So, I understand why you are telling that Lempy is bossy, because Lempy is always showing this strong woman profile, but is it really like that? It can be like that sometimes, but most of the time when there is a meltdown as Lempy, I'm the one that is strong and is supporting her when she has her crisis. Because, you know, one thing is to show confidence and to show like strong woman figure, and the other things is to be like that also when there are some stressing and important moments in the relationship. Sometimes Lempy also have meltdowns and I'm always there for her to support and to be the like the point rock of the relationship, let's say like that.
Are you trying to say that I'm not controlling?
No. I say it sometimes you are, because as you said, you like to show something, like you like to show your opinion and you are also like strong opinionate, so sometimes it's take it or leave it for with you, but thank goodness for you, I'm more like of an accommodating person, and that's the secret of our relationship. It wouldn't be working that well if we were exactly like that.
I would say to the controlling thing, I don't think I'm controlling. But I just like to make sure that my point is heard. That's the thing.
Yeah, yes, absolutely.
Because when we are when you're discussing something that we want to do or anything like that, you're kind of, you're approaching from soft. I don't want to say no, because maybe to offend Lempy, you approach it really soft. But for me, it's rather like, oh, if I say yes and it fails or whatsoever happened that is not good, that I might just prevent it by saying no. I just like to say my opinion straight. Here, yes or no.
Yes.
I don't think I'm controlling, to be honest. Yeah, Alice too soft is... No, there was a comment that says our relationship is not real because Alice too soft even to be a man or something like that. I would say from an African household, I know that my brother, for example, raised differently a little bit more. They don't express emotion that much.
And I don't express emotion neither, do I? You're always complaining that I don't express emotion.
No, you don't cry, to be honest.
Yeah, I do show emotion, but I'm not somebody
you
that...
You show a lot of softness.
Yeah, I do. I'm a sensitive person, and I'm proud of it, because people usually eat that... hard and harsh, they just miss out on life so much because they don't get to appreciate little things that I do.
Yeah, because I think the why this point is there is because like a man cannot be soft or something like that, but I think for me, I don't really care. What I care about is that our relationship is working.
And that's what
and
you should care
my
about.
My character is a little bit too strong, and I just feel if I had somebody also like me, I don't know how many arguments we'll be having in the relationship. Hey!
And we are so different. I mean, I also, when I think that something is, it needs to be discussed, and it needs to, you need to change one point of view, I always like come to you and work on you, because first time with Lempies, when you come with like, you should change your opinion on this because this is really important. I will not make an example, but there is an important example that happened recently. It's really no, no, no at the beginning. So you really need to be trying to go a little bit around the bush and make her day by day change her opinion, showing them and giving reason. She's never going to say yes to something just for the sake of accepting an opinion.
Respecting
a man. You need to convince her, you need to sell every time your idea and really let her understand that your reasoning is better than her. Otherwise, it's never going to be accepted. That is like, and that's what something that I learned that I think is really keeping the relationship together. I mean, in my opinion. If I was like just on a strong opinionated man, I would just say, you know, go your way, because that's what it is.
I take your idea, and so when I understand them, and also when I have my idea, I present them by trying to make sure that you understand them. But yeah, another thing that we also wanted to talk about this, you know, when you've been in a relationship for a long time, there's a lot of arguments. That's also we discussed in the video before about leaving YouTube, that couples on YouTube try to reflect that relationship are super sweet, nice, everything is nice and calm and beautiful. That's not what it is. To be honest, there's a lot of arguments. It's not like there's a lot, but like any other relationship, there are arguments. The only thing is that when we are filming, that's time for work. We focus that on work. And there's no way, I think it doesn't make sense that when we're arguing about something, maybe in the evening or so, I go get the camera and say, I'm capturing this for YouTube. This is why it doesn't show up there. But we like normal people, sometimes there are also arguments and blow up. Important thing, apologize. I think secret. I'm sorry.
No, there are some secrets. Like, first of all, even if you are, you need to train yourself, even if you are angry and you have a blow up, you need to keep it cool. Like, do not exaggerate, do not use bad words towards your partner, because that is going to make the relationship go on a bad level. You don't want that. So try to keep it cool, even if you are pissed about something. Do not swear, do not use bad words. That is fundamental. Another thing is, understand the stress or the moment that your partner is going through and the reason for the relationship. So somebody needs to understand the moments and also just say, you know, yes, whatever, just, you know, okay, it's fine. And then later, when the blow-ups come cool down, you can go back to the person and say, you know, we had this discussion about this. But there are certain moments that maybe it's because we have pressure from our work or we are stressed on our own and we have this blow up, and you need to let it go without insisting too much and
to
maybe
solve the problem
at the moment.
You can't, when you are pissed.
Yeah, you cannot solve when you are pissed. Like, we have some strange behavior, so we're never going to go to wreck because we are so much into the moment. You need to leave it go and sometimes just say, yes, you're right, and then facing a little bit later, when your partner has cooled down, you go back and you really solve the problem. Sometimes we also get comments and on the things. For example, when I was living in Italy for 3 months, and I was living here at Lempies in Germany alone,
abandoning you,
people say, ah, I know this relationship is going to go wrong. You never need to leave your partner alone for such a long period. But actually, it's really important and healthy for the relationship to spend some time apart. Like, to be always together is nice, but then at certain points you also need to have some you time. That is fundamental for your person, and also not to get too, you know, too much of your partner, not to take your partner as granted. Like, it's always make you appreciate the relationship more.
So basically, I think you need time to kind of miss each other, because when you are living together all the time, you don't really miss. So you need a little bit of time just to take a break, to appreciate that person, like a week away, to appreciate how important is that person in your life and miss them. And when you come back together, You even feel stronger than ever for each other.
Yes, you feel stronger than ever. You appreciate missing is amazing. And also, to be honest, after you spend sometimes apart, also sex, when you go back, it's better. Isn't it?
I don't know about that one. No comment. But I think what I also like about when we spend time apart, when you're in a relationship, sometimes it makes you feel like, oh my goodness, I'm kind of losing who Lempy is. And now it's just Lempy and Ali. And I take those time to actually write my goals and kind of rediscover myself. Like me as a person, as an individual.
Yes, yes.
Because when you're together, sometimes you're just focused on Lempy and Ali as an entity. Then you need a little bit of time to look back and say, this is who Lempy
yes.
is.
A little bit of me, myself, and I, you know what I mean?
Yes, like I need a date with Lempy to talk to Lempy freely when you're not at home with somebody.
Also to Ale, I mean.
When you're in a relationship for a long time, the love kind of changes with the year and the time together. Initially, love is more like intimacy, and later it's more, there's more growth, there's more time spent together.
Yes,
it just
that is project.
And you as a couple should go along with it, because definitely you're not going to be stuck at where we're at the uni. And
yes, like we have been together now almost 8 years. We cannot pretend that our love was as like it was 8 years ago. It was really a primordial love. I mean, it was mainly sexual. It was mainly
living together. When you're not living together, you kind of do your own thing with your friend, and it's something that you enjoy now. It's obviously it's also different from what we have had, that we have had before the uni and stuff, but love evolves. So it's,
yes.
It's okay, be open-minded, and just
be
don't be
open-minded.
Afraid when
you
are
know,
changing.
There are many people that just wake up one morning in a relationship and just say, yeah, you are not used to, like you used to be, you know? You just,
yes.
You don't give me present anymore, or I don't know, you don't give me the same attention. Yes, I don't give
I
you
don't
enough
have
attention.
A full-time job.
I have a full-time job. We have kids together. I cannot be there only all the time.
That
you know,
is
it's, sometimes it's important.
It
like,
is
it's
important.
The fundamental, for sure, to have some of this moment. But they cannot be as much, or it cannot be as intense as they were at the moment you met with your partner, because loves evolve.
Yeah, like if I look, if I honestly look at how we were when we met at the uni and now, we can't spend that much time together doing nothing in our apartment. We were like, we were just students on student scholarships who we didn't even think about how to make, how to put food on the table of anything. Basically study for test, and most of the time you spend time in the apartment lying, watching TV, all that. So all that is time spent together, and now you can't say, oh, you're spending less time. Of course I understand, but the time will never be as much as what we spent before, because
of
now
course.
There's more things, like a real life.
Yeah.
We are living now a real life situation. Anyway, guys.
That was it for today. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Please, if you did, remember to leave a comment and a like to this video. That helps us to support this channel.
And also, if you don't like the video, still leave a comment. And maybe leave that, but at least a comment to share with us what you think we should improve in our next video.
Yeah.
Ciao, ciao, ciao.
Bye.